In this video, we'll discuss metabolism. Before we do that, let's review work, energy, and power. We'll use these later on. Work is force times displacement times the cosine of the angle between them. Suppose you're dragging a wagon across a horizontal surface. Because you're exerting a force in the same direction as your displacement, you're doing work. So we have F, the displacement, and the angle between them, cosine of angle. When you do work, you're transferring energy. And if you measure the amount of energy produced or consumed per unit of time, you have power. Power is the rate at which work is done, which is work over time. So how does this apply to metabolism? Food is stored chemical energy. There is energy conversion occurring in our bodies where the stored chemical energy in food is converted into work, heat, or fatty tissues. When the chemical energy is converted into work, we can do physical activities. For example, 9% of the energy intake from food goes into usable mechanical work when lifting weights, and 20% is transformed into mechanical work during bicycling. So, most of the chemical energy from food is actually converted into heat. And if you sit around all day and eat junk food, the converted energy will go into stored fat. So the body's metabolic reactions, for example, cellular respiration, extracts energy from food by taking electrons away from food. This produces ATP, which is used to provide energy for the body. The rate at which the body uses food is called the metabolic rate. We also have the basal metabolic rate. This is the amount of energy per unit time that the body needs while at rest. And the energy consumption is also proportional to oxygen consumption. We can measure this using an apparatus that measures oxygen consumption during activity as pictured here. We can measure energy consumption this way because the process of digestion oxidizes food, meaning it takes electrons away. Now that we have covered metabolism, we can discuss useful work in humans, such as lifting weights. Lifting weights is a form of mechanical work and does not include internal work, such as the work done by the heart and lungs. Now going back to energy, is exercise good for losing fat? If you need more energy, such as when you exercise, your body uses the chemical energy stored in fat. We'll use an example to see how this applies to energy and power. Suppose you need 12,000 kilojoules of food a day, but you consume 13,000 kilojoules. This is a difference of 1,000 kilojoules. You wonder if bicycling would help burn off the extra energy. So start with power and rearrange for time. For power, use 400 watts, which is the value you can get from your textbook for the energy consumption rates. 400 watts is the total metabolic energy consumption rate for bicycling at typical speeds. It includes the basal metabolic rate. We get 42 minutes a day. This is how much time you need a day to burn off the extra 1,000 kilojoules of energy. Note, this is kilojoules, not calories with a small c, that you may be familiar with. Let's say you use 13,000 kilojoules, but consume only 12,000 kilojoules. How large is the fat loss? To get this answer, use fat loss equals the difference in kilojoules times the energy content of fat, which we will use as 39 kilojoules per gram. When we plug the numbers in and calculate, we get 26 grams of fat that we're losing. This might seem like a big number, but remember, we're using kilojoules. Now let's compare the metabolisms of a human, a reptile, and a hummingbird. Why is this important? Metabolisms vary across species. Humans usually consume many meals a day, and often too much food ends up going into storage. The amount of calories we need depend on our physical activity level. Compare this to a lizard who has a lower metabolic rate and doesn't need to feed as often. Reptiles have a different metabolism than us, a and rely on heat from their environment to get heat and energy. They're literally solar-powered. Compare this to a hummingbird who needs to feed about every 10 minutes to maintain its high energy levels in order to fly around like a tiny helicopter. But if the hummingbird was as big as a human, it would need to consume a huge amount of food in order to be able to sustain itself. This comparison shows you that metabolic rate relies not only on the amount of food consumption, but also on lifestyle.